Previous video itself, we have seen about how what is the virtualization and how to create the instance and configuration and all. In this video itself, how to create instance and installation of the instance, installation of the Ubuntu on the virtualization framework. We can use VMware, VirtualBox and Microsoft Virtual PC, anything we can use. In this class, we are using Oracle VirtualBox. So, I am opening this Oracle VirtualBox. I'm going to take a look this VirtualBox itself, creating one new instance for installing Oracle, for installing Linux, Ubuntu Linux. For that, first I have to open it, second I have to create a folder. Create a folder for installing that VirtualBox instance, Virtual VMware PC. So in the VMware itself, I am creating new folder for installing one new virtual instance, VMware instance. So new VMware training, I created one folder. Then now I creating new instance Ubuntu training. Type is Linux, version is Ubuntu, let's see. See the memory size default they have given 512 MB. But it is not enough for Linux box itself. So I am increasing the RAM size for 2 GB. Where I am taking from the 2 GB, I am taking from the host PC itself, I have 4 GB of the RAM. In the 4 GB of the RAM resource itself, I am sharing for my Ubuntu Linux instance for that. So I am creating new virtual hard disk, create the extensions VDI VirtualBox disk image. That is hard disk. Now I am creating hard disk. Then dynamically allocated, that I explained that previous video itself. Why we are going to choose this dynamically allocated as well as fixed size, I explained that. Now I am going to giving this option for dynamically allocated, then only I can able to accommodate this hard disk if my installation goes beyond the my level, beyond the my desired level, automatically it will expand. That is the concept. So Ubuntu training the name. So now it's 8 GB RAM is default. So I'm going to create this 8 GB and location once again that I've created folder, this hard disk I am going to fix in this folder itself, where I am created the folder already, that VMware itself, VMware new training, there located the folder, I have saved that, I creating that, the VDA folder, that VDA type of hard disk. Now I have created the instance. See how much size of the memory, 2 GB, and type is Ubuntu. Everything I have created. Network also I have created. Now what we have to do? I am going to start installation of Ubuntu. So before I have to choose the storage, that means CD drive I have to install required. So I am going to choose this. This is my CD drive is empty now. I put my installation CD on that, virtual CD on that. Choose my virtual image CD, ISO image CD. Where it is located itself, ISO itself. I kept on that drive its EDAV itself. Now I am going to installing Ubuntu desktop version 14. This is ISO image file. I choose that. Yes. Now I took the CD for the CD drive. What I am going to install in that operating system Ubuntu, that I have took my drive itself. Now I start installing. I hope that it is started. Ubuntu 14 desktop version installation has been started. Now installation started and going on that installation. In this screen, we can able to see two type of installation. One is try Ubuntu and install Ubuntu. The try Ubuntu is, we does not need any changes in the existing system itself. Just we can install alongside of the Ubuntu existing operating system itself, just install. This is install Ubuntu wherever the operating system we need to install permanently, that option you can choose it. Now I need to install permanently in this virtualization itself, VirtualBox itself, so that I am choosing this install Ubuntu option. I'm going to install the Ubuntu operating system from the installation CD, virtual CD itself. I already taken that. Now I'm choosing this option, install Ubuntu. I am continuing the installation. The installation type, this computer currently has no directed operating system. What would you like to do? Actually, I'm going to choose this option, first option, erase this and install Ubuntu, which is the partition I have took that 8 GB of the hard disk size. So in that completely empty hard disk. So that I am choosing this option, erase disk and install Ubuntu. So I have particularly the 8 GB of hard disk. I chosen that. So I don't need to anything delete or erase in that hard disk because already it's completely empty. So that I choose this option. Now it's automatically partition table has been created. This already it is taken for creating file system and partition. The extended 4 partition is going to creating and swap partition also going to creating. These are the important partition. While installing Linux, there are 3 important partition is required. First is root partition, second home partition, third swap partition. So it's already been going to creating. Now I am going to choose location. Location is India. India and Kolkata. Continue. Now I am giving the username Now installation is completed. Finally, it's asking restart now. after giving the restart command, you remove the disk from drive. Now, new instance itself, Ubuntu Linux installation is completed. Now, it's booted Linux box. My new Linux box is ready now. Now installation started and going on that installation. We can able to see two type of installation. One is try Ubuntu and install Ubuntu. The try Ubuntu is we does not need any changes in the existing system itself. Just we can install alongside of the Ubuntu existing operating system itself. Just install. This is install Ubuntu wherever the operating system we need to install permanently. That option you can choose it. Now I need to install permanently in this virtualization itself, virtual box itself. So that I am choosing this install Ubuntu option. I'm going to install the Ubuntu operating system. From the installation CD, virtual CD itself, I already taken that. Now I am choosing this option, install Ubuntu. Continuing the installation. The installation type, this computer currently has no directed operating system. What would you like to do? Actually, I'm going to choose this option, first option, erase disk and install Ubuntu, which is the partition I have took that 8 GB of the hard disk size. So in that completely empty hard disk, so that I am choosing this option, erase disk and install Ubuntu. So I have particularly the 8 GB of hard disk, I chosen that. So I don't need to anything delete or erase in that hard disk because already it's completely empty. So that I choose this option. Now it's automatically partition table has been created. This already it is taken for creating file system and partition. The extended 4 partition is going to creating and swap partition also going to creating. These are the important partition. While installing Linux, there are three important partition is required. First is root partition, second home partition, third swap partition. So it's already been going to creating. Now I am giving the username. Now installation is completed. Finally, it's asking restart now. Now new instance itself, Ubuntu Linux installation is completed. Now it's booted Linux box. My new Linux box is ready now.